So last week, we end with a call to you. We said, only you can help clean up some of the bullshit that's invading our digital environments and our everyday lives. But I kind of want to take it a step further. I actually think it's our ethical responsibility to call bullshit when we see it. So what we're going to talk about today, we're going to talk about spotting bullshit. What are some of the alternative explanations to a claim that you might run into? What are some of the motivations of the person that's making that claim? What, you know, what if we were given something to buy, we would sort of question these kinds of things. Like if you go to a car dealership, for example, you would probably put your radars up and know this person's trying to sell me something. And we want to create these habits of mind going forward. We also want to teach you some of these tricks and methods for estimating plausibility quickly. We'll talk about that. We'll talk about something called the Fermi estimation today. So for the readings, we put Carl Sagan's chapter on the fine art of baloney detection. I think this is one of the better, most concise, one of the better readings out there that's incredibly concise for sort of consolidating all the different ways that can make you better critical thinkers. He talks in here about not falling in love with your hypothesis. I think that's something we all do. We're human. So when we have an explanation to something that we've seen, we want to be right. And if we're wrong, it can completely shake our world. He also talks about trying to get it independent, or get it facts by getting sort of independent confirmations of that. He talks a lot about Occam's razor. I think a lot of you have heard that throughout your university experience here. The simpler explanation is generally the better one. Now these are things, that, again, we want to create this habit of mind. Second, and that is just simply ask who's making that claim? Who is, you know, what is their motivation? What are they trying to sell you? And what do they gain from it if they give you that information? That sounds a little cynical, but you need to be a little bit cynical. Again, if you were to go to the car dealership, you should be asking these kinds of questions because you know they're trying to sell you something. You know what their motivations are, and you know what it is, what's in it for them. They're going to get some sort of commission. So we want you to have that kind of frame of mind when you're going forward. When you graduate the University of Washington and you go into your professional lives and in just your everyday life, you should put that skeptical hat on, especially when you're in these digital environments. You need to be careful on the toilet, you guys. These are some internet memes that I'm going to put out there, and we're going to try to figure out whether these memes are true or not. No one tells you this, but more than 30,000 Americans are injured each year in the process of using the toilet. Bullshit or not bullshit? So here's where you'll go to the poll everywhere for that particular question. All right. And the answer, well, what the survey says. All right. So we have 66 of you going up. Going some, not bullshit. Most of you think this is bullshit. It's not bullshit. This one's true. People really do get injured on toilets. In fact, just as a side note, oh, there he goes. All right, I like this. Live action. This is adaptive thinking. Whoa! Right. I wish the world worked like this, if we could really switch our opinions. Well, actually, they probably do switch our opinions really quickly. How did they switch that? Oh, you could switch your answer. Good job. I probably should knock that out of the options on Poll Everywhere. Okay, so here's the thing. There's a little side note. So people, has anyone heard of the Valsalva's maneuver? I know there's 30 biologists in here. Does anyone heard of Valsalva's maneuver? Valsalva's maneuver is when you exert and you raise your blood pressure and people pass out. And people above 65 tend to, if you look at the numbers, this is from a real study, you'll find that a lot of people do get injured by toilets. Okay. All right, next question. flip the bell peppers over to check their gender and sweetness. You may have seen this food fact meme. Some of you may know the answer. Some of you may not. Is this bullshit or is it true? Are female peppers more sweet than the male peppers? Okay? All right? And the survey says, for those that said bullshit on this one, you are correct. There's at least 30 biologists in this class. So you better have got this. Fruits are enlarged ovaries, so they can't be, there's no sex to them, let alone gender. So this one that's been passing around the internet is sort of false. All right, this one was passing around, especially because we're here in Washington State. They were talking in this story, it talks about how big these warehouses are that Amazon owns, a lot of the property that they own, a lot of where AWS is stored, and there was a claim that the Amazon real estate is about the same as the Amazon rainforest. Bullshit or not bullshit? True or false? I'm ready, survey says. So this one is bullshit. And this one is really far-fetched. So, all right, here we go. This is good.
Guys, good. I'm giving you credit no matter what you answer. Yeah. You don't have to change. It's all good.
Yeah, you're all going to get just points for doing these. This is easy points. It's one credit class, guys. You guys are good. You guys are going to probably start messing with this real soon. All right, so let's do one more. Candle flames contain millions of tiny diamonds as they contain all four known forms of carbon. BS or not BS? Survey says?
Oh.
Oh, now this one got you guys. This one was the hardest one. This has been talked about for thousands of years. A lot of writers, philosophers, people from religious studies talk about what's in a flame. And recently there was a chemist at St. Andrews that looked at this and they did find that there were about 1.5 million on average, you know, depending on the candle size, and a lot of nanoparticles of diamond. They sort of get burned up afterwards, but this one's true. And again, you would have to know something about chemistry, but what we're trying to do here is just put in that skeptical hat. Then, you know, we would expect you here then to drill in, to look for that article from St. Andrew, and you could start to sort of become better and better at that. I get these things wrong a lot too. And what we're going to focus the class on is specifically around data, but this is just sort of a warm-up because we see this kind of stuff and it gets us thinking and gets us critical of what we're seeing.